Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Felt Biscuit. It's been a while since we visited the tavern, hasn't it? Absolutely. So let's remedy that with a little bit of Hearthstone. We're going to be playing the latest Tavern Brawl, which is actually really, really good. I was surprised to see that because we've been getting a lot of repeats lately, which is not really that fun. I like to play some new stuff. And this time around, we've got something called Miniature Warfare. And the principle behind it is very simple. All of your minions are 1-1 and only cost 1 mana. So there's all sorts of really cool things you could do with this particular idea. I think one of the most obvious ones is you would take a minion that spawns more than one minion and use that. So you're getting a 2-for-1 deal for the most part. You know, something like a Silverhand Knight, which would usually spawn a 4-4 and a 2-2, is now going to spawn 2 1-1s, but it's going to spawn it for 1 card and 1 mana. And really, to me, in this brawl, maybe the most important thing is the value of the cards, because the value of mana is now gone. So you're more worried about getting the most efficiency out of each card instead of getting the most efficiency out of your mana. You're looking for big value. And any card that spawns multiple creatures is going to do that. Like Enixia. I mean, this is ultimate value. This is 1-1 now and costs 1 mana, but it summons 7 1-1 whelps. Or is it 6? I believe it's 6, yes. It fills the board one way or the other. So this is amazing value. Dr. Boom's pretty good value as well. It's really nice because you're going to get really great trades out of that. And I've picked some other stuff like that as well. Matter Bomber's cool because everything's 1-1, so Matter Bomber's probably going to murder the board. But there's other things you can consider as well, like, well, what if I buffed those creatures? So, I have Competitive Spirit in here, for instance, you know? If I got a bunch of 1-1s, and then they become a bunch of 2-2s, and that's awesome. I also have things like Shattered Sun Cleric for the very same reason. You know, I can give a 1-1 buff. I have the Keeper of Alderman, which is a Paladin-specific card, set attack minions attack and health to 3. So, that's a big deal. You play a card, it's 1-1, suddenly you can triple its HP and its damage, so that's nice. And then you can think about things like Frostwolf Warlord, which actually gain bonuses for how many minions you have on the battlefield. I think there's a good opportunity to play a really crazy flood style with this and just flood the board with 1-1 minions. One other thing to consider is that since all of the minions are 1-1 and cost 1 mana, which means that really their body stats don't matter, their battle cries and their death rattles become infinitely more important. So there are some creatures with some really cool battle cries that might work quite well. And I've got a lot of battle cries in this deck, so I also took Crowd Favorite, which buffs itself up every time you have a battle cry. I mean, I'd also say that something like a Questing Adventurer is probably really good here, because you think about it, Questing Adventurer is usually 3 mana, 2-2 start. It's 1 mana, 1-1 start now, but all of your cards that are minions anyway also cost 1 mana. So you're going to buff that Questing Adventurer up real fast. So that could be useful. I was thinking about that. I took a little Exorcist because I think that a lot of people are probably trying to play Death Rattle heavy decks. So a little Exorcist will be really powerful here. Since it's getting 1-1 for each minion, it's going to tank multiple targets. And since I'm playing a Paladin, I was thinking, well, let's do some Muster. And let's combine that with Justicar Trueheart. I actually had a game, I've only actually played like 1 or 2 with this deck so far, where I got this turn 1 and was able to play it. So on turn 2, I could spawn 2 1-1 minions, which actually put me in a really cool position. The weird thing about that, though, is that as long as you have cards in hand, you're going to want to play anything that's not that, because it's probably going to be better. But you often run out of cards because of how quickly you can play them. So I decided it would be a good idea to sort of spice the deck a little bit with some spells, because they take more than 1 mana for the most part, and things like Divine Favor are very useful for refilling your hand. The main problem with Divine Favor is that a lot of players are also dumping their hands, so you can't really get a lot out of it. So I'm thinking of maybe swapping this out for something that has more guaranteed draw, maybe. Muster Battle is obviously cool, especially when you combine it with a 1 mana Quartermaster. That's huge value there, so those are really powerful. And I threw Sacred Trial in there because the stipulation allows for the enemy player to play a lot of minions, so Sacred Trial's kind of a good way to shut those down quite quickly. I'm not 100% convinced about it. I can't quite remember if it kills it before the battle cry goes off. I can't quite remember if that's true. If it does, that's amazing. If it doesn't, yeah, it's okay. Lowertheb's in there because the same reason that I put spells in, the enemy's going to put spells in. AoE board clear is really powerful here. So you can take some really weak board clear like Arcane Explosion and Consecrate and Holy Nova, and they're probably going to wipe the board out. So usually good to be able to secure your board before you throw down a bunch of buffs and use Lowertheb to do that. So I like that idea. That's why I tossed that kind of thing in here. But there's all sorts of ideas. There's some really, really awesome stuff that I've seen played here. So we're going to dive in with our Paladin deck and see how we do. I think there's a ton of potential for creativity here with all sorts of kinds of decks, which is why it would be wonderful. You could say multiple brawl decks, Blizzard. Mm-hmm. Yes. I don't think you're getting away with it. I know. I'm well aware. You can't hide it from me. Don't say it's too complicated. Trust me. All right. Here we go. Let's see what we come against. I've run up against a mage or two so far. Looks like we're going to be running up against a warrior who bought a $10 JPEG. Says the guy who bought thousands of dollars of cars. Ooh, Dr. Boom just caught Truha right off the bat. Really strong, actually. I like this opening hand. It's really good. Do I play Justicar first or Boom? I think I play Boom. So right now, you know, how useful is Justicar? I mean, we really can play both, actually. In fact, Dr. Boom Frostwolf Warlord is probably a really good opener. Something that no one will ever say ever again after this week. There you go. Yeah, I'm thinking Dr. Boom, Coin, Frostwolf Warlord. Because that's like, that's a 4-4 now. I mean, how does he fight a 4-4 on turn one with this stipulation? It's pretty difficult. So let's see what he comes up with. I imagine there are some really cool things that you can do, though, to counter that. Sylvanas Windrunner coming out. And a Whirlwind. You sneaky bastard. You sneaky bastard. That was the perfect counter, actually. It's okay. We got this. Have some more 1-1s. Hope you enjoy them. I hope you don't have another Whirlwind. Let me put it that way. Oh my god. Ah! I should have seen that coming. I like this as well, because there's an armor warrior would be really effective in this. Thank you. We got a matter bomber. That should shut this down. Good lord. That was brutal. I can't believe I lost Onyxia so easily, but hey, there you go. Go on. Deal with him. Get it. Nope. Just... I didn't pray to Bomber, that's the problem there. Alright, let's get Justicar True Heart out, so I've got this. Because I'm burning rapidly through cards here, and so is he. And Divine Favor's not going to be that helpful. I really think I need to scrap Divine Favor from the deck in favor of some more reliable card draw. Because in this stipulation, they're going to throw down so many cards that you're never going to get good value out of this. This is not good at all. Oh my. We do, however, have Muster for Battle. And Silver Hand, so we're going to be able to throw a lot of stuff down here. So I think we're going to have to do that. This also gives me a way of killing Kalthazad, so I actually just counted this pretty much perfectly. Happy with that. Cool. So we just use that, and then we take a swing, kill that off. There we go. I'm thinking, yeah, throw it on the Shadow Zone. Why not? Let's get the buff out of there. Sure, why not? You know, maybe saving that for a higher value creature that actually has a board effect every turn. Like... I don't know, some of those cards are not really good in the stipulation, because you think, oh, Ysera, great, Ysera for one mana? Yeah, but what do you get out of that? Because Ysera's going to die. Like, keeping her alive is very difficult. It's possible to protect them. I think you could maybe build a deck around buffing those really high-value minions, like throwing down, say, what's his face? Baron Geddon, you know, and have that as a constant board clear. That might be pretty cool. Right, well, Divine Favor is totally useless here, which I think has sort of vindicated what I said earlier, that this was a very bad idea. I don't want to throw Loetheb down right now, because what's the chance he top decks a card that is a spell that is really, really helpful? Probably pretty low. So we're going to hold on to Loetheb for the time being. He's no good on the board as a 1-1 body anyway. That Alexstrasza is really good, though. I like that idea in the deck, simply because it's a lot of pinging. So you're probably going to want to deal with that. But I have board control right now. It's not brilliant board control, but it is board control nonetheless. Maybe some heals would be good too. The thing is, right now, even with these dead cards in my hand, I can still summon 2 1-1s every turn. So that's really strong, I think, compared to what he can do, which is just rely on his top decking. So unless he's able to clear my board again, which is possible... then I think I should be fine. The problem is doing enough damage to him because of that armor... So let's see what we come up with. Sacred Trial, I mean, we might as well put that out. Sure, why not? I'm half tempted to burn my hand so I can get a draw out of it, but that's a very bad idea with what I've got. Thing is, you know, I keep summoning two. As long as I can keep my board up, that's fine. You know, something I really think I'm missing from this is a Stormwind Champion. That would be a huge add to the deck. So I'm thinking, you know, maybe get rid of Divine Favor in favor of something that reliably draws and see if I can fit Stormwind Champion in here somewhere. That would be huge. You know, literally doubling the value of anything on the board there, which is a big deal. The problem is keeping it alive, because they just take that out immediately. I've had someone play that against me before, and it just didn't work very well. Weapons are quite good, too. I think actually what he's doing here is incorrect. I'd actually just go for the win. I think maybe the answer to this is you bring up... You play Warrior. Oh, this is terrible. You get a bunch of board clear, and what you do is... All you do, in fact, is you just hit him in the face with weapons. You ignore his minions, and you out-armor him, and you just hit him in the face with weapons. Because he doesn't have the DPS to bring you down. I could also argue that a pure mage spell deck might work here. It is slow, I will admit that, but if he plays a lot of minions on the board and you're able to effectively clear it with something like Arcane Explosion and Arcane Missiles and things, just cheap spells, then you can start just nuking his face, and he won't be able to gain enough board control and enough damage to kill you. Especially if you throw in a couple of those really lovely secrets. You know, throw Ice Block in there and Ice Barrier to keep you alive. There's another possibility. This is why this is so cool. Like, I knew it! Should have seen this coming a mile away. Oh, I said Geddon was good, and well, yep, it just proved me right. At least I can kill Geddon this turn with the... This is a great weapon for this, by the way. Light's Justice finally has its day, but yeah, that's pretty bad. All right, well, that's awful, but let's throw down Lotheb now, put down two of these, and then Defender of Argus. And that should allow me to... I mean, I can't keep Lotheb... It doesn't matter if I keep Lotheb alive. It doesn't matter, because it's only a 1-1 body anyway. So we're just going to throw it down. There we go. I might just burn this one Divine Favor, because there's no way I'm using it. Like, it's just a card in my hand that's holding me back, so... We're going pretty slow here. I don't think there's a risk of fatigue, because we don't really have a draw for that, but we definitely need some more reliable draw to give us some more options, so I think we refine the deck after this. But yeah, gotta lose Lotheb. That's fine. You know, ultimately that's damage, and it's using a weapon charge, and that's fine. He's now starting to build up some stuff in his hand, which is good. We might be able to get something out of that. Little Exorcist, you're not very good right now, but I might dump you anyway. I'm half tempted just to throw out the Consecrate, but it's a bad idea, because if he is able to flood the board, I need that. So, let's just go... I mean, we have so much mana, we can just empty the hand anyway, and we're slightly outdoing his heals, so we're winning right now. So let him build up some... Now we're not. Death Spite is going to screw us completely here. That's a great choice, because of its AoE. That's not brilliant. I'm not too happy that that came out, but... We do just pull a Keeper of Alderman, which is good. That actually would allow one thing to survive the AoE from Death Spite. The main problem is that he's just going to hit whatever that thing is. So the way that I would avoid that is by throwing out Little Exorcist. There we go. Don't want to throw down two Silverhand minions. Use Keeper of Alderman on this guy. Actually, I think it's objectively better to play on this guy because of Quartermaster, so we should do that. And then throw out another little dude and then go for the face. Yeah, we're going to lose most of the board, but we're not going to lose all the board. And the little Exorcist prevents him from just chopping through and killing my 3-3. So this is value, I think. This seems like the way to go. And then, if he holds on to more cards, we can throw out this Divine Favor. Yeah, obviously he's going to AoE and destroy most of my board. That's accepted. They're all 1-1s. Who cares? We can replace them. We're a paladin. It's not a big deal. Has he got nothing? That's great. That's great news. Love it. Matter Bomber. Yep. I'll take it. Sure. I don't mind killing my own thing. Because as long as some of those hit his face, any of them would be nice. Like, more than that, maybe. You're a traitor, Bomber. You're a traitor. You've always been a traitor. I knew it. Do I throw a Consecrate now? No. Let's get Divine Favor. That's two cards. That's fine. I'll take it. Shadows and Cleric. That's nice. Competitive Spirit. Also nice. We can do all of these things and more besides. So let's throw down that. There we go. And out goes the Competitive Spirit. So if these guys stay alive, we're in great shape. I mean, we're in great shape now anyway, really. I think he's probably going to die, but you don't know. I mean, he can revenge now to kill everybody, so that would suck. Is he really killing a... He's killing a dude over the 2-2. That's surprising. Huh. Oh, well. Maybe he knows about the Quartermaster thing. Shield Slam on the 2-2. Least effective Shield Slam of all time right there. Competitive Spirit procs, which is always nice. Gives us a little bit more damage. Frostwolf Warlord, love it. Perfect. Perfect. So good in this mode. So very good. There we go. Love it, love it. And we can't kill him just yet, but we're getting there. Looking good. Hopefully, he doesn't pull enough burst to kill me now. That's the thing. He needs 5 damage in hand. Does he have it? Does he have a charge? He's got a charging minion. Oh, no. It didn't work! He has more! He's put Reno in the deck. Yes! Success. Wonderful success. I thought I was dead. Reno is a big, big choice for this one, isn't it? But you would have to cut down a lot. Like, you'd have to have such a crazy variety of cards to make Reno work here, but... That's pretty cool. That's a really fun mode. This is awesome. But let's do some refinement. So, obviously, Divine Favor has proven itself to be pretty much worthless. So, we need more reliable draw. So, what we got is a Paladin. Well, Blessing Wisdom is not that reliable because the stuff gets killed too easily. Lay on Hands, I think, is the way to go. Because that's going to give you... the Solemn Vigil's not bad either. But I'd probably go with Lay on Hands because the heal is really effective. It's a bit late game, so we can empty our hand a little bit and then we can replenish later with Lay on Hands. I like that. Anything else that should really go here? I still like Matter Bomber. I think Quartermaster's great with Justicar. It gives you that sustain because you can just keep pumping those minions out, which is really effective. I think maybe Little Exorcist was a mistake. I'm not actually seeing as much Death Rattle as I expected. So maybe we take out Little Exorcist and maybe just put in a little bit more card draw. Let's maybe throw in Solemn Vigil. That seems like a good idea. Holy Wrath is not bad in this deck, but it's not brilliant either. So let's put Solemn Vigil in. There we go. That should be nice and cheap as well. So now I've got a much more reliable draw. And we've got some pretty good fights here. Do we have enough battle cries to justify crowd favorite? I think we do. It's like 2 battle cries, 4, 6, 8, 10, 9, 11, 13. Yeah, we got enough battle cries to justify crowd favorite, no doubt. I like how this looks. I think it's good. So let's go with that. I'm maybe thinking Sacred Trial is possibly worth cutting, but let's do another game with it and just see whether or not that's true. I love this. I love the creativity that this can bring to deck building, because deck building is so much fun to do, but the problem is that in ranked mode, you're going to be fighting against guys who are using decks that were built by pros, that were neck decked, and you can't really outbuild them. Now, you can come up with something cool and maybe it wins in a fluke, but most of the time you're going to lose. Whereas in Tavern Brawl, I really feel like you can get creative and not be punished for it. Now, I've played a couple of Majors before, and they're pretty good in this mode because of things like Arcane Explosion. They have a lot of board clear, so it's not entirely surprising. I'll keep the Lay on Hands, honestly, for later, so I like that. Matter Bomber, I like crowd favorite right here, I think, is a toss. I think we toss two of these and see what else we get. I like Matter Bomber, though. I definitely do like that. Bit too much draw in the hand, but not too bad. Mage is good here for obvious reasons. I mean, ping is guaranteed you just kill anything, unless it's been buffed, so... I never thought of that. I mean, it just spawns a 1-1, but it becomes a 1-1, so it actually gets to attack. What else does that? There'll be a few others that do that. I just don't know how beneficial it would be. Muster for battle. Yeah. Problem with Matter Bomber is it's going to kill that and then the thing's going to spawn out of it, which is not brilliant. I think actually the best thing to do here is actually not to play anything and to muster for battle on turn 2 with coin. That seems like the way to go. Because Matter Bomber doesn't make any sense here. It's just going to kill the egg, but then the thing's going to pop out of it and trade. So why bother? Like, let him get some more stuff on the board, then Matter Bomber. Now maybe Matter Bomber. I never thought of that. Yeah, that's another thing that would be cool. Muckless Champion, Cavaldia Raider would be really good. I think Warlock with the Floating Eye would be really good too. Now is definitely a time for Matter Bomber. I like that. So we'll go with Matter Bomber here, and then we can buff the Matter Bomber so it can actually fight. And maybe force him to use a ping, which would be great. There we go. Matter Bomber mostly doing its job. Didn't actually kill that, which was a little annoying. But never mind. There we go. And now we just buff that up. Because honestly, like, if he uses 2 mana, that's 2 creatures he could have played. But he seems like he's running low on cards quite quickly, so... I'm thinking maybe more early draw is good in this too, just because you need to play so many cards so often. I thought you'd just go purely spell heavy. I would love to do just a pure spell deck here. I think it might be quite good. Okay. Yeah, sure. That's fine. Oh, we have Muster for Battle, Quartermaster, and we can do them both. How good does that feel? How often do you get to do that? Not very often. Yeah. Ooh, you're gonna feel terrible now. That's gonna sting. Secret Keeper, you can go to hell. We're not letting you stay up. If he starts playing secrets, we're in big trouble. Look at that. Look at how good that was. I'm almost going to have to play Solemn Vigil as well. Yeah, I would have too. That was... yeah, that was Paladin the Rectoning, that one. That was completely brutal. Nice. I'm liking this. Didn't get to use my new cards, but I think it worked out pretty well. Didn't even need him. I mean, that Quartermaster muster for battle combo is just so brutal. And you can do it so early, comparatively, you know. 3-3-3s on the board at that stage. How do you even counter that? You know, you've got to wait for Flame Strike, really, and then by that point it's too late. There's too much board control. You can't even afford to play anything on the board because it dies instantly. So, you know, I think what would be fun would be Flame Leviathan in this setup. I think that would be really enjoyable to play with. Just get that instant 2-2 explosion as soon as you draw it. Okay, Consecrate's always nice. I think we toss the competitive spirit, we toss the crowd favorite because we can't reliably play it yet, and then we see what else we get. That's not good. Hopefully we get another minion. Obviously playing Keeper on its own is terrible. Game, we need to have a talk. This isn't funny. You might think it is. You might think you're just having a little joke, but I have very fragile feelings. And I'm about to get even more fragile by the looks of it. Ugh. Nasty. That's really bad. This is even worse, because I think we might have too many spells in this deck. I think we might have overdone it. Maybe we have to cut the Solemn Vigil, because I think maybe that's too many spells, because we end up in this position. Dr. Boom is obviously an incredible turn one play, because it's going to do damage to me, it's going to control the board, and if he plays like a Frostwolf right now, I'm in big trouble. I don't like that. That, because Thaddeus is still a 1-1. So I don't see the benefit. I like North Sea Kraken, because, you know, 9 mana for 4 damage and a 1. Yeah, I'm glad I held on to Consecrate, let me put it that way. Thankfully, this won't do too much damage. I should be able to lay on hands out of it, but... oh, ouch. Yeah, this is a really strong turn for him. Matter Bomber possibly coming to the rescue here. All right, Matter Bomber, show me what you can do. Here we go. Bomb, bomb, bomb. Yep. Good, 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 good. Yeah, mostly good. I like it. Ow, ow. We could have done without that, but never mind. You know, we'll take what we can get. And then I can set his attack and health to 3. I can play Solemn Vigil now, because pretty much everybody died. So let's play Solemn Vigil and see what else we get. Maybe we get something that helps. We don't. So I can set his health to 3. I think maybe it's worth doing because I don't want to take 6 to the face at this point. And we do have another one. So yeah, let's do that. Set it to 3-3. Better than the 6-5, I say. Captain Obvious to save the day here. That also sets us up for potential consecration next turn if we trade one in and then consecrate the whole board. We'll see what he's got. But I've taken a huge beating. I'm thankful that I put Lay on Hands in. That Inspire, that could be a problem. Thankfully, the Consecrate, no, is not going to do the job. Yes, it is. Yeah, we've got it. We got this. It's fine. Or we can Mustard again. I think Mustard is just too powerful to ignore here. Yeah, I think we go Mustard. And then we put Quartermaster. And we kill off the Bone Guard Lieutenant. And then we've got a bunch of 3-3s that can fight his 3-3. And he probably... yeah, I mean, he can't clear that board, surely. You know, he can't play Holy Nova. He's already used his coin, I think. Has he? Shredder's quite nice. I think any minion that spawns another minion is probably pretty good. But I really do like, in this mode, cards that have an immediate board impact. Because that just gives them value beyond their 1-1 self. That's the Inspire going off, which has been annoying. But we've got this board pretty much cleared now, so I'm not too worried. Do I want to Consecrate here? Let's see. Let's see what kind of trades... because if I Consecrate, I can run that 1-1 into that, and that kills everything else, and then we trade, and everything's peachy. So, yeah, I like Consecrate here. And then we can Boom, which is also cool. So, I like that. Get that out of the way. Ship's Cannon comes down. We then just kill that with the sword. That's not a sword, that's a hammer. Total Biscuit, how many pills have you been taking today? And then we're heading for 9, and there we go. We are in a great situation now. Look at this. Suddenly the tides have turned, my dear. And as long as we can survive a couple more turns, we should be able to win. That's the question, though. With the beating we took early in the game, can we survive? It almost makes you think like you should throw an antique heal bot in, just so that around this time, if you've been taking a heavy beating, you can just last long enough to get Lay on Hands out and then secure the victory. But maybe I'm overthinking a Tavern Brawl. I don't think I am, though. I really think that Tavern Brawl is the opportunity to do all that theory crafting, all that thinking. And it encourages you to use cards, which are in other circumstances really, really bad. So, I think you could do some cool stuff. I think you could actually make Junkbot playable here. You know, you just play a pure mech deck with Junkbot and just sacrifice a bunch of mechs, and then your Junkbot is huge. Anything which buffs up Muckless Champion is amazing here, if you can pull that off. Which you should be able to, you know, in pretty much all situations. I think Muckless Champion would be incredible in this brawl. Well, he gave up. Don't blame him. He got kind of battered to death a little bit there. That played out really well for me. Pretty happy about that. Can I get Mucklers in here? Maybe we get rid of Crowd Favorite and put Mucklers in, because Mucklers does more than Crowd Favorite does, I think, in this brawl. So let's kill that, and let's put Mucklers in instead. And I think we're going to get rid of Sacred Trial and put something else fun in. Is there anything fun on Inspire that would be worthwhile? Murloc Knight, no. You could play a Murloc deck because of the buffing. You could do it. Interesting. You'd need a lot of draw. Maybe we should try that after this. But first things first, let's get rid of Sacred Trial. And let's think of another Inspire. What would be okay here? Cavaldia Raider, probably. Nexus Sirad is good too, I think. Silverhand Regent is pretty good, but I think it would die too easily. I'm thinking, yeah, I think Cavaldia Raider is really good here. Do I really only have one gold Cavaldia Raider? I do. How disappointing. I am a scrub. All right, let's play that. That looks better. Then we should just try a straight up Murloc deck with draw in it. Because every Murloc costs one, they've all got synergy, and they can buff each other. So they're all pretty weak anyway. So making them 1-1s makes very little difference. And then if you make sure to be able to buff them, then I think that will be really good. So if we got like a draw heavy deck with a bunch of Murlocs, I think we'd be in a great situation. So yeah, that might be worth trying. I'd probably run it with a Warlock so I got enough draw. Alright, well, I like Mucklers here, but I don't really have anything else to go with it yet, so... Oh my god! The combos are real! Okay, so what we need 4 mana to pull this off. Oh my god. Consecrate probably kill it, but... Yeah, this is... yeah, we play Justicar first, and then we go Onyxia Frostwolf, and then Muckless Champion. This is sick. All right. Cool. Let's see if he plays the same thing. Well, I like this. You know, good turn one to trust Justicar True Heart. Or Trustacar. Very good. Let's see what he's got. Draw. Yeah. So he realizes, you know, he realizes the whole Paladin thing. Haunted Creeper. I never considered that. That's a really good card to have here. You know what's better, though? What I'm about to do to him. So, we don't pop that Haunted Creeper, for obvious reasons. We go Onyxia. I'm a moron! I just realized how stupid that was. But it's okay, because he can't get rid of that, most likely. So, he's going to kill off one of the whelps, and then I'm going to have space from either Muckless Champion or for Frostwolf Warlord. I think Muckless Champion is the best call here. So, get rid of one of these. Play Muckless, and... Ooh, a redemption. That's unpleasant, but okay. Redemption's great here, too. I keep thinking that. Yeah, restore it with 1 HP. That's fine. And then Muckless Champion the entire board, right? That's the way to go. I am so stupid. I keep forgetting. It didn't matter. Oh, man, I am so dumb. It's like, no, I can't play because I filled the board. Twice I made this mistake. Twice, and I won anyway. This is brutal, actually. I'll play one more game with this, and then we're going to switch it up, because, you know what? Winning a lot, while fun, maybe is not as entertaining to watch, especially when people leave as quickly as they do, which is a shame. You know, the thing is, I think that, like, in this mode, you've got such a potential to swing back because of the low damage on the board that you should never quit out so quickly. I think that's weak sauce, and I'm not impressed by it. Okay, Defender of Argus is good. Keeper of Alderman is good, but only if I've got something to play it with. We don't need Lay on Hands yet. Let's keep Solemn Vigil out as the kind of mid-game draw. And that isn't helpful either, but never mind. So the hope is that we draw a minion off this, and then we can go minion, coin, keeper. And that's a great start. Oh my god. Yeah, that's pretty strong. Thankfully, it's not going to survive very long. These are all not ideal for the situation here. I'm not hugely keen on it, but we can make it work. Probably just throw the Shattered Sun out on its own, and then just set its health to 3. That seems like the way to go. It's not brilliant, but, you know, it's kind of wasteful, but getting a 3-3 out on the board this early seems really important. Those leper gnomes are a pretty cool idea. The problem is, like, Mechgineer dies too easily. Because he's 1-1, unless you can buff him up or protect him in some way, it doesn't necessarily seem like it's worth playing that card. Because maybe you get one leper gnome out of it at most, and that's it. Is it value? Yes, kind of, but it's not brilliant value, I don't think. Wow, we really had no better option than that. That's quite surprising, actually. That's really bad for him. Alright. Well, I'll take it. Mustard, good. We can use that later. I'm thinking we're probably just buff a dude, just Defender of Argus here, honestly. Competitive Spirit, maybe? On two minions? Is it worth? Nah. Let's hold on to it. We can use it for Mustard. That'll be much better. So I'll have to take a little bit of damage here, which will suck, but let's see what he's got. Wrath, okay, sure. I mean, it's probably quite a spell-heavy druid deck, which would be good, because Swipe is obviously amazing in this duel. I'm still not convinced about this Fugan Starlink thing. I'm not really sure why people keep bringing this up, because do they think that Thaddeus will not be affected by it? Because it is. Mustard is obviously the way to go here. There we go. That's what confuses me about it. I think maybe people assume that Thaddeus, because he's summoned and not a card that's played, will come in as a 12-12. That's not true. All the minions come in as 1-1, doesn't matter how they came up. That's a nice counter, but we'll be able to clear the board with little dudes, so that's not too bad. Again, another shapeshift, which, you know, just indicates he just doesn't have many answers, which I'm fine with. That's okay. Muckler's Champion, hello, you could be very useful here. In fact, actually, Lowertheb, Mucklers, and Reinforce, I think is absolutely the right call here. I'm doing this the right order, yeah? Yes. Yeah. Gotta make sure that comes out the right time. There we go. That is too good. And then I swing in for the win here. These kind of suck. It's gonna be unfortunate that we have to deal with that. I think I'm gonna hit that. I think that's the most efficient way. Yeah, we're gonna lose some dudes. It's gonna happen. I accept that. I've learned to accept that and move on. Please don't kill my Muckless Champion. Please don't kill my Muckless Champion. Actually, come to think of it, maybe that wasn't as good as I thought. But I got Solemn Vigil out of it, so it was good. So I get two more cards out of it, so that's actually great. The problem is he can just kill Muckless Champion now with his hero power. So I think maybe later we don't play Muckless Champion unless we have a way of getting it above 1 HP in this matchup. Because otherwise he just kills the Muckless Champion immediately because it's too big a threat. But he did waste 2 mana doing it. So, you know, that's another thing that he can't play. That's a cool idea, but it's just the wrong time to play it. So, let's go with Reinforced Quartermaster and Competitive Spirit. I mean, obviously. It's too good. This is way too good. Now, this is almost playing a kind of Eboladin-style deck where it's just reliant on Silverhand Recruits. And because everyone is 1-1, me being able to summon 1-1s at will is really powerful. So I do like Paladin in this matchup. I think it's very, very powerful in this brawl, by the looks of it. Let's see what else we got from him. I think after this, we're going to play a Warlock Draw Murloc deck and see how that works out. Because again, I'm not... You know, this is cool. I'm winning every game. That's neat, but let's try something more interesting, you know? I hate it when I accidentally come up with good decks. That's the worst. Don't do that. Makes the game boring. Hearthstone's much more fun when you play bad decks, trust me. I mean, it is a children's card game. You know, let's not take it too seriously. Ouch, but not too bad. Competitive Spirit's gonna trigger, which is awesome. Oh, he's gonna hate life. And I wouldn't blame him. Because this is horrible, and nobody should be subjected to it. Look at this. This is disgusting. This is disgusting. I'm almost tempted to madball my own board, just to make it fair. A swipe would, of course, be devastating here, but we already know he's used one, and he has over half his deck left, so what's the chance he has another one? Guess we're about to find out. All Starfall? Yeah, that's true. That's very powerful. That hurts. But he is going to still take a ton of damage, and we might actually be able to kill him with Mad Bomber. We're going for style? We're going for style points. We're going to make it happen. Alright. This is what I call... my MB styles right here. Oh, greater Bomber! Bestow upon me your blessing! Ha 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 ha! Sweet, it's so sweet. That was fun. Okay, I will take that. But let's try something different. Okay. This deck's too good. Don't play it. Let's try something else. Murlocs. Murlocs and draw. Can we make this work? Let's find out. Mortal Coil, super powerful here. Really good. Power Overwhelming, potentially pretty good too. What else is good in the Warlocks? Let's see. Are we going to see Reliquary Seeker see play? Yes, we are. We're going to make it happen. We're going to make this work somehow. Okay. What else we got? I like Curse of Reform here. The reason I like it is because, especially early game, I think it really limits their options. But, I mean, do they really care about 2 damage? Probably not. Maybe not. Let's see what else. Blood Imp, really strong here. Obviously, AoE kind of screws it over, but the buffs are good. Oh, crap. Did we just find a use for Demon Fuse? Actually, screw a Murloc deck. We just found a use for Demon Fuse. You kidding me? Look at this. We're going to make this work. Okay, let's see. Dark Peddler is probably good here. Yeah. Tiny Knight of Evil. Can we make that work? Whenever you discard a card, gain 1/1. I don't discard many cards, though, do I? I don't think I'm going to have a reason to have that. We'll come back to that. Demon Wrath is amazing here. That's great clear. Wrathguard, nope. Sends demons. Yes, draw. We like it. Yeah, so we're not going to go for a Murloc deck. I've decided to go with something more interesting. That's bad. Imp Gang Boss, bad. Void Terror, bad. Actually, not bad, but not great. Fist of Jiraxxus, nah. Not keen on that. Implosion, really good, I think. Shadow Flame, not so brilliant. Hellfire is going to clear my board as much as it is theirs. This is useless, so we don't want that. Let's see. Bane of Doom is a random demon guaranteed, but that random demon is going to be 1/1. Dreadsteeds, yeah, sure. I mean, they're 1/1s anyway, and I get to play them for 1 mana. Why not? Fel Cannon, no. Pit Lord, definitely not. That's the worst idea I've ever had. Let's put Demon Heart and let's put Demon Fire in as well, because, you know, buffs are great. Floating Watcher, I think, is really good. Anima Golem is probably awful. Yeah, obviously, it's terrible. What am I thinking? Dread Infernal is excellent. Not keen on Dark Bargain. Wilfred Fizzlebang, pretty much useless. Actually, not really, because it does remove... It's not useless, it's just not brilliant. Lord Jiraxxus is good for a weapon, I think. And we'll throw Mal'Ganis in there anyway. It does buff the other demons. If I can buff Mal'Ganis, then I can keep him alive, so I like that. So yeah, we're going to go for a demon deck. So we've got pretty much what we need here. Do we just throw Bane of Doom out for the sake of it? I mean, most of the demons don't really have effects that are ongoing. That's the main problem. So it's like, hey, I kill a dude, but if I only get a 1/1 anyway, then I don't think Bane of Doom is good. I think we just throw a Void Caller out. Yeah, let's just go 2 Void Callers. Cool. Yeah. So that's got plenty of draw. It's got Mortal Coil. It's got my hero power. And obviously a bit of discovery here with Dark Peddler. So I like that. It's got Sense Demons, which is good too. Yeah, demon deck. Cool. Let's make it happen. I like it. I don't think I missed anything too obvious. I think maybe the only thing I could have done was probably throw in Illidan so that I could have got the nice little 1/1 elementals out of that, but otherwise, I think it's pretty good. Let's give it a try. Hopefully it works, because there's some really interesting cards in there that I've really never played before, like Demon Fuse, which is still probably terrible. Even in this brawl, I think Demon Fuse is still bad. So, we'll see. Dark Peddler for a start is good. Demon Fire, good. Demon Wrath, I like that. We probably want to toss at least one of these, though. Let's hold on to Demon Wrath and see if we can get some other demons. You're just taking the piss now. Alright. Dark Peddler is kind of cool because... Oh, yeah. That's a good card. I keep forgetting that. Oops. Alright, well, Dark Peddler I think is good here. Dreadsteed, though. Let's throw out Dark Peddler, and then we'll see what we'll get, and then maybe we'll coin it, or maybe we don't. Flame Imp, bad. These are all pretty bad. I think Corruption's probably the least bad. coin Dreadsteed. It's never going away. It's gonna just sit there killing you. Love it. Unless it's got a silence, in which case I don't love it. I haven't actually considered silence much in this brawl. I think it has some utility. Why do you I thought it was a warlock for a second. Like, why does he have that? Yep, sure, get rid of it. That's fine. Dreadsteed is going to kill everything you own. I need a way to replicate it. Yeah, if I took Baron Rivendare, I'd be able to replicate it, but this works for the moment. So we kill one of those, we get another Dreadsteed back. And I think we do have to life tap here. A coil, nice, good. So we have Demon Wrath next turn if he throws down a ton of stuff. And if he doesn't, then we probably just Mortal Coil and build the board back that way. I'm still wondering how effective just a face deck would be here. That's nice in this. That's pretty nice in this duel. It's not going to survive, but it's nice in this duel. Give him credit for that. Which is kind of why it's weird that he played him, because he can't possibly believe that I'm going to let it live. I think Demon Wrath is probably just the way to go here. Just get rid of all of this stuff. Just get it off the board. Is it worth it to get rid of three dudes, though? Nah, I don't think it is. So instead, let's just Mortal Coil and see what we get off that, because maybe that will be more useful. So we'll Mortal Coil that, just in case he has a way of bringing it back into his hand. We draw another Demon Wrath, which is, yeah, but whatever. And there's a tap. Cool. Okay, works. He's got a lot of HP, but I think I'm going to wear him down, because I don't think he's going to be able to keep drawing at the same rate that I am. So I think I'm going to establish. I hope I'm right on that, because if I start to burn out, I'm going to be in big trouble. But I've got buffs aplenty. Demon Fire is not maybe ideal for a Dreadsteed, but it's good for other things. Do we just implosion that? And then that just gives us full control of the board and gives us a bunch of imps? It is quite expensive for what it is, but yeah. I still like it. You know, I got three imps out of it and I got that off the board, so hey. And then once we start buffing with Demon Heart and Demon Fuse and Demon Fire, he's not going to be able to keep up with me, I don't think. He thinks he's safe right now because he's behind a wall of armor, but... Oh, Chillmore, ouch. That sucks. Because he's probably holding the dragon, let's be honest. Mal'Ganis is good, but not quite good enough for this situation. I think, do we have to accept that we're going to lose the imps? Probably. I can buff one of them past the damage threshold, and then everything else just dies, but I really want to hold on to Demon Heart for Mal'Ganis for next turn. I don't think it's worth otherwise. So I think we just have to accept that the board is lost. So we just get rid of it. Hey, he may not have a dragon. He has a dragon, but hey, that's cool. Sense demons here. And then next turn, we go Mal'Ganis and good old Demon Fire here. Ooh, Floating Watcher, yeah. Good, but not brilliant in this situation. We need it later. So, do we play the Dread Infernal? Sure. No. No, why would we do that? That's dumb. Don't listen to Total Biscuit. He's an idiot. He's a super idiot, as it turns out. Wow. Maybe I should pay attention to the number of cards I have in my hand. Blizzard, please add a card counter because I can't do basic mental arithmetic because I have the mentality and strength of a child. What? Ow. That's not very nice. Oh, Reliquary Seeker. We'll get to play him eventually. Okay, it's fine. We're not dead yet because we have Mal'Ganis and we have Demon Heart. We're good. We are good. We are immune. That's now a 6-6. And now you're in trouble. Hopefully he can't kill it this turn. I guess we're about to find out. I don't want him to be able to burst me down. That sucks. But he's alive for a little while longer. We can make him work for one more turn. Damn, I wish there was something I could do about that, but there isn't. Oh well. Do we just put Demon Heart on something else? Put Demon Heart on the Blood Imp would be pretty cool. Then you can never AoE that ever. I think we've got all sorts of opportunities here. We've got all sorts of cool stuff. I think, you know, maybe put a Demon Fire on it. Maybe just don't invest the Demon Heart. That might be a little bit excessive. But let's go Floating Watcher because we're immune. So we can tap. Reliquary Seeker is almost good. Can we make it work? We don't have enough minions. Damn! I almost made Reliquary Seeker work. Oh well. Not quite. We'll get there. We'll get there. We'll get there with an implosion, I can guarantee it. Maybe we sense demons again. That's three. What else is better? Probably just Demon Fire the Blood Imp. Or demon fire the floating watcher so it doesn't get nuked. No, I mean, that's already been buffed, hasn't it? Did it get buffed? Yeah. No? Oh, because they didn't take damage, of course. Yeah, okay. We're demon firing that. Yeah, because I want that to live. Okay, cool. There we go. And then we just hit him in the face for a million points. And Mal'Ganis dies and then everyone cries. But it's okay. I'm sort of hoping that he doesn't have AoE to kill our Blood Imp, because that Blood Imp is going to be really useful. Well, he has AoE to kill it. That sucks. But I can buff it past the point where it will die, so that's not bad. We can just throw a Demon Heart on it. That would be quite the investment, but I think it's going to pay dividends in the long run. Hello, Jiraxxus. You're actually kind of useful here. We might want to play you, but I do get rid of draw, but honestly, like, I've got enough cards anyway, so I think that's okay. So, or do we just play... Yeah, we go Demon Heart here. And then we don't remove stealth, because he will probably be able to kill... No, we should remove stealth. It's so much damage. We can't afford not to. Do we play Jiraxxus? It does give me the ability to hit him. So that's not too bad. And it lets me... It gives me the paladin ability. I can summon 1/1s now. Look. Hey, mommy. I'm a paladin. Look. My aspiration to life has been fulfilled. Look at it. There we go. The worst infernal. Just the worst. I'm sort of making this work. I mean, it's not quite working the way I want it to. I'm disappointed not to be able to use Reliquary Seeker properly yet, but... Is he going to execute my Blood Imp here? It feels like he is. I think he's just going to try and kill me. Yeah, he's just going face. I don't necessarily blame him for that. This sucks. But I can- Hey, hang on a minute. Hang on a minute. Alright, you want to see the sickest play? You're going to see the sickest play here. Alright, here's what we're going to do. I'll do this. Yep, which is cool. Dreadsteed's fine with that. He can take it. He's a man. Yep, we like it. And then this. And then this. And then we suddenly realize that we can't play a Reliquary Seeker because our board is full. Why am I so stupid? I mean, that was, it's still a sick play, right? You gotta admit, that was still next level. We just need one more- we need one guy to die, but only one. Here comes the Whirlwind. That's not a Whirlwind. That is. Ow! Reliquary Seeker, I'm so sorry. I failed you. I got too many imps! I didn't think I'd get that many imps! Oh, that's not good. Did he have something on the board? No, he didn't. So, yes he did. So I don't like that. That's... I'm so close to dying. Oh, Reliquary Seeker, I'm so sorry. Okay, well, this is bad. But hey. Dread Infernal. I was gonna go Demon's Wrath, but... Oh, kind of, what's the point? I should play that. Oh no, this hurts me too. I should have put some heals in this deck. I may have made a mistake. Void Caller, okay. A Floating Watcher, yes, but I don't take damage anymore, so it's not good anymore. I'm okay with... The Void Caller is actually bad, come to think of it. Just because, like, who cares if it summons the guy, and it also ends up not using the Battle Cry. So I think actually Void Caller was a dumb thing to put in. Alright, we just dump everything on the board and hope he can't kill me. So close! It's never gonna happen, Reliquary Seeker. It's never gonna happen. Maybe we get one more game just to make you work. I'm gonna make this guy work. Girl, work. Oh, come on! You really had your second one. You have over half your deck left. Oh no. 50-50. 50-50. 50-50? Please. Please. No! Oh, damn it. Oh, we almost had that one. Ouch. Okay. Right. So, changes. Void Caller sucks. It goes away. It's useless. You know, oh no, it summons another guy from my hand that I could have easily played anyway. What's the point? Sacrificial Pact for healing, I think. I think we need Sac Pact. I don't think there's any other demon that we'd really want. This is awful. This is awful. This is awful, unless you buff it. Void Terror maybe has some limited use, but not brilliant. Void Callers, yeah, get rid of those. Void Crusher, awful. Doomguard, awful. Unless you combo it. Fearsome Doomguard, also awful. I mean, this is okay if you combo it with Demon Heart. Certainly, I can get behind that, but I think Sacrificial Pact is the way to go. Because we get a bunch of imps, you know, we can use Implosion to summon things for Sacrificial Pact, and that keeps us alive. So, alright, let's try it again. We're gonna make Demon Fuse and Reliquary work, guys. It's gonna happen. I promise you this. I promise you upon this Warlock's Grave, upon the Skull of Gul'dan, that we're gonna make this work. I'm determined now. It fills me with determination. Let's see what we have. Oh, it's a mage. Alright, well, that's bad. We're gonna get blown up. Demon Fuse, yeah! We have it. That's a card we have now. Reliquary Seeker, I don't want you so early. Floating Watcher, you're okay. Dread Infernal, you're okay. Demon Heart, alright. So, probably nothing turn one. Unless, because if he pulls, like, double Mirror Image, then yes, I'd go with that. Because weirdly enough, Mirror Image, of course, being stupidly good spell, does not give you 0/2s anymore. It gives you 1/1s, which actually makes it quite good. I mean, not that it was bad in the first place. No. But I think it's pretty good in this brawl. Okay, come on, Golden Mage. Rush. Yeah. So you're figuring out your high-level strategy, are you? Or are you checking if I'm streaming? Come on. Get a move on. La da 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 da. Finally, good. Thank you. Let's see what we have. You know, I don't think that's that great. I mean, it's good, but I don't think it's amazing. Simply because it does 2 damage. Okay, well, my guys have 1 health anyway. Who cares? Dread Infernal just to wipe him out? Or let's hold fire for the time being. Let's get a bit more value out of that Dread Infernal. It also gives us information, because if he Fire Blasts us in the face, then we know that he's got very situational cards in hand, so we can kind of play around that. And if he plays minions, then great, we blow him up with the Dread Infernal, and everybody's happy. Okay, so it looks like he has some fairly situational cards. Okay, we can work with that. Not yet. No. You can wait till later. That is a terrible idea. Alright. Dread Infernal, no. Floating Watcher, coin, tap is okay, but then he'll just go Fire Blast trade. But it does give me big card advantage. The alternative is Floating Watcher, coin, Demon Fuse, which is pretty good, actually. Yeah. Here it is, folks. You're actually seeing it played. Demon Fuse. There you go. That is a real thing that just happened in a game of Hearthstone. Admittedly, it was a tavern brawl, but you get the idea. That's now a 4-4. That's what it was originally supposed to be. So, we're in a pretty good spot now, before he polymorphs it. Oh, a North Sea Kraken. Yeah, that I guess would do it too. Okay. Alright, well, let's see if he dumps down a bunch of minions now, and then we could just drop the Dread Infernal on top. Oh dear, that was... Well, we can at least kill the Stormwind Champion, but this is still not brilliant. I was hoping for better than that. And no Demon's Wrath, which is terrible, but okay. At least we kill off the Stormwind Champion, so it's not too awful. Tap. Yeah, or Demon Fuse again. Yeah, sure. Let's go with the second Demon Fuse. I'm giving him a little bit too much mana here. I'm not really too keen on that, but if he only has 4 cards, can he really do a lot with that? The answer is yes, by the way. Mirror Image, okay. And Arcane Missiles, that's not good for me. Not at all. Dinged it a bit. I take back what I said. Fire Blast rank 2 is pretty good. Oh, God. No. That's a whole... No. Don't... No. That's awful. Why would you have... No. This is a problem, if you hadn't already realized. This is actually a terrible, terrible thing that just happened. That is an incredible card for this brawl. That is amazing. And it just got worse. Alright, we need some major board clear really fast. And he'll probably just kill me anyway with a million arcane missiles to the face. So... And that's not board clear at all. That is not even close to board clear. Jaraxxus, we can... Let's see. 7, 8, 9... 9 Jaraxxus next turn for the heal. Hope that he doesn't have 2 in hand. I think that seems like the only way to go. Demon Fire on the Blood Imp. And bring it out of hiding and start beating on people with it. Or actually, you know what? Straight up Demon Heart on it, I think. I'm tempted to Sacrificial Pact, but I'm going to take the risk. I'm going to take the risk that he can't do the damage he needs. Here's hoping that I'm right on that. And that he feels the need to kill the 6-5 instead of me. I may have made a horrible mistake. Let's find out. Does he have what he needs to kill me? He's going face. So maybe he does. Here's hoping that he does not have a spell. Please do not have a spell. Please don't have a spell. You're a mage. You probably have a spell. Rag. 50-50 on the rag. Okay. 50-50 it is. Oh no! Oh. I completely forgot he could do that! Oh, live, live, no! Oh, that stings. Mm. We gotta get a win with this deck. I believe in it. I believe in the power of Demon Fuse. I probably shouldn't have believed in the power of Reliquary Seeker, but you know. Oh dear, that could not have gone any worse. Mmm. Yeah, I kept forgetting you can kill your own Ronin when it's 1-1. It's not 7-7. You can kill it. Damn. The heal probably would not have saved me there, because it would have opened me up for that exact same Ronin play and 9 damage to the face. So I think I actually could not have saved myself, but... Alright, Demon Wrath, yes. Demon Heart, that's a little too late. I think we want to... Do I really want to toss Implosion? No. Wait a couple of turns, use Implosion. No minions. That stings. Hopefully we get one off the top. Maybe a few too many spells in this deck. Sense Demons is fine, but if I'm not drawing any minions, then I'm just sitting there not doing anything. But I have enough clear, I think, for the early game not to be that important. You know? Because if he plays a bunch of minions, I'm just going to Demon Wrath him. So who cares? You know, or I'm going to drop a Dread Infernal on him. So that's fine. I don't mind this. You know, what kind of early game damage can you really throw at me that's even going to be significant? Not much. Not much. I don't think. Far as I can tell. Let's see if he can prove me wrong. Probably. After what happened last time, I would say it's quite likely, actually. I really messed too much with this board. Just like to break everything. There we go. That's pretty. Very nice. It's a really nicely designed board, actually. I gotta give credit to the art designers for this. Come on! You've only got 1 mana. There's not much you can do. Gotta move on. Mush. This seems a little upset. What you got? What do you have? That's a cool card. Yeah, that's a really powerful card. I had never thought about using Wobbling Runts. That's awesome. I think the correct answer here is to do nothing and see if he uses 2 mana to ping it and then drop Demon Wrath on it. Do we really want Demon Wrath? That, yeah, probably we do. Let's let him build a board first before we make him cry. It depends if he buffs or not, but the best answer here is to leave it up and to not put anything up against it that he can do. It's fine, because I haven't got a minion I can play anyway. The only other thing I could have done was the Demon Fire. I could have coin tapped, which, again, I mean, it's not amazing, you know? Not great. So, I don't mind too much. Come on. Mush. Get a move on. Not many choices to make here. If he plays another one, then I'm going to be very happy. Acidic Swamp Ooze, yeah. That's a fair pick, considering I think weapons are really strong in this brawl. Mal'Ganis, you are not good on your own, bro, but I can Demon Fire you, but then he will throw everything at you to kill you, so I think we hold on to you for the time being. I think the best option is to tap and just get more cards at this point. Establish my card advantage, give me options, and then Demon Wrath is bored. Maybe force him into pinging his own guy to unleash the 1-1s and then Demon Wrath him. Because then he doesn't have as much in terms of mana to use that turn. So I like this. That's a draw. Okay. I'll take a little bit more of that. That's not a big deal. I don't want to play Mal'Ganis right now. That's obviously a silly idea because it'll die. We do have Implosion, which is pretty good. I could implode the Acidic Swamp Ooze, possibly, on a coin, and that would give me a bunch of 1-1s. similarly, that, yeah, I still think that's a good idea, because that sets up a potential Mal'Ganis follow-up play. So, I like that. Let's go with the coin implosion. Get rid of that, get some imps on the board here. Yeah, of course, that gives him something he can run into, but it gives me a bunch of demons. So, I can Demon Wrath if I need to when he pops. I can Mal'Ganis. I can then Demon Fire my Mal'Ganis to take it above 1-1. Yeah, these are all good things. I like it. What do you got? Anything fun? Arcane Missiles? Yeah, should have seen that one coming. Ow, ow. Could have been worse. Could have definitely been a hell of a lot better, though. I think I'm getting all my demons killed here, which is not good. That sort of shuts my play down, but hey. Okay, might be a Demon Wrath time. Oh, I love how they made them all different. That's neat. Rascally Runt, Wily Runt, and Grumbly Runt. I don't recall ever seeing this card outside of the adventure mode, and I'm not even sure. I think I just silenced it and killed it. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. Mal'Ganis is not really an option now because he's got stuff on the board to handle it. I'm thinking probably we just Demon Wrath and then pass. That's probably the way to go. Just clear those 1-1s off the board. Yeah, let's do that. Get rid of those. Don't play Mal'Ganis because they'll just get pinged immediately. And we can hold on the Sacrificial Pact for later. I don't think we need to use it right now. Okay, so maybe next turn we get to Mal'Ganis. Coda Rider. That's a pretty good one. I like that. Although the Coda Rider is obviously essentially identical to the Silverhand Warden or whatever his name is. I probably should have saved my Demon Wrath. Thankfully, I have another one, so no biggie. No biggie. We're good. Yep, just Demon Wrath him again and tap. He's surprisingly flush on cards, but then again, he has used both of his card draw cards, so I'm not too worried about that. And we can heal after this, so that does mean I did use both my Demon Wraths, so I am relying now. Yeah, so he's going. This deck is purely value minions, so it's spawning multiple minions. I do have a decent amount of AoE, but maybe not enough to handle this. So this could get ugly. Okay, I think it's implosion time, probably. We could play Mal'Ganis, but then again, it dies immediately. We can't buff it. So that's unfortunate. We could just play Mal'Ganis and Demon Fuse the thing immediately. Or we just go Mal'Ganis Demon Heart and hope that he doesn't have a means to kill it. To be fair, there is a high chance he has a means to kill it. There's also a high chance that he has AoE. So even if I do implode and get rid of this and get a bunch of imps, he can probably clear them anyway. But that's going to be a risk regardless. Does he have a single target? Let's find out. There we go. Do you have a single target removal? That's the question. Because if you don't, you're in trouble. So, let's make the assumption that perhaps he put too much AoE in his deck and not enough single target removal. And let's hope I'm right. I'm probably not right. It's actually very likely that I'm incorrect. Strongly, strongly incorrect. Let's see what you got. Go on, bring it on. What you got? What you have is my lack of patience and your slow play. Can you answer that 6-6? Please say no. Please don't answer it. Because I'm out of AoE until I draw my next Dread Infernal. He's going to be able to get rid of it. Ouch. Probably. At least, you know, he's going to run a lot into it to have to get rid of that. So, it's not too bad, but I'm still a little upset that he's going to be able to get rid of this Mal'Ganis by the looks of it. Oh, I tanked two of them. But that does mean ping and kill. Well, at least he invested a long turn into getting rid of it, but still. Yeah, he comes out ahead on that exchange. But I do have a card advantage. So, this may be my savior here. So, probably implosion on the Stormwind Champion is good. And probably sends demons. We should sense demons. No, we shouldn't. I was thinking we should sense demons first so we can use the explosion from the Infernal to wipe this, but because these are 2-2, that won't work. So, implosion on the 1-1. 3 imps. I like it. 3 mana, probably sends demons, or alternatively, we Demon Fuse. Do we Demon Fuse? I don't see anything wrong with having a powerful demon on the board, so let's start buffing up. Let's use that Demon Fuse. I'm gonna hold on to this till later. I'm gonna make you work. I don't know how, Especially when I've used both of my implosions, but I'm gonna make you work, I promise. I should really put a Nyxia in this deck. Just build an entire deck solely around making Reliquary Seeker work. It's just like nothing but token spawns. Yeah, that'll be... Well, he did have to use a Flame Strike to clear that. So, I mean, I'm not... That's okay. You know, he had to use some pretty strong removal and burn his entire turn to do it. Unfortunately, that does leave me in a position where I don't really have any minions. So, Reliquary Seeker. I think you're getting played, but let's see what we get off the top. Dark Peddler, okay. That's an option. Possibly Mortal Coil here. I would like that. Zombie Chow, that's a terrible idea. Yeah, Corruption is the only reasonable option here. Do we... Well, we can't Demon Heart that because it's not actually a demon, so... Reliquary Seeker is also not a demon. So we can't actually buff it. Demon Fuse is not a demon! Well, Demon Fuse is a demon, but Reliquary Seeker is not a demon. So we have now discovered why Reliquary Seeker is really bad, because it doesn't synergize with any of this. Sense Demons is all we get. Dread Infernal, good. Board clear, like it. Blood Imp, also pretty good. Let's get rid... You know what? Hang on to it. Hang on to it. Put the Blood Imp down instead. I like that better. I'm thinking Pact. Nah. Keep that alive. I like the 1-2. Don't Pact yet. Once we blow up his board with this Dread Infernal, then we can Pact. Here come the buffs. I just have this feeling that that's a Defender of Argus. Is it a Defender of Argus? I'd love to know. Can you tell me? Are you going to show me? No, it's worse. Okay. Yep, that's terrible. That's really, really bad. That's awful, actually. But we may still be able to survive regardless. The Dread Infernal is now... Oh, dear. Lost that too? Oh, no. Ah, this is the worst, by the way. Oh, dear. Dread Infernal is not going to do the job now. We need another Dread Infernal. You are not that. Do we tap for another Dread Infernal? We've only used one, right? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, so we have 9 cards in hand, so we can tap. Okay, tap. You're not a Dread Infernal. You're not a Dread Infernal. Hmm, is that would that timing work? If I play Floating Watcher, does it die before... I think it dies before it gets buffed. I think. I could be wrong. At least we can get rid of the Muckless Champion. It's just this Cavalier Raider is going to be a nightmare and a half. And I'm probably going to have to Sacrificial Pact just to keep myself alive at this point. The Demon Fire would not kill that. Corruption. We can buff it. I'm within nuke range right now. The problem is you can keep buffing the Cavaldia Raider, but Demon Heart would kill it. So we can hold on for another turn, I think. Do I want to play the Watcher? I did this completely wrong, didn't I? I tapped before Watcher. That was a huge misplay. You know what? Throw Corruption on it just to make sure. And you know what? Reliquary Seeker, you're just going out there. You're going out there. You're going to go do whatever. Yeah, I massively misplayed that. I should have played Floating Watcher before I tapped. So that was a huge mistake. Okay, well, we have our Lord Jaraxxus here, so this damage is not that big a deal, and we can kill the Cavaldia Raider. I'm not it's dead anyway. I'm not even convinced about Emperor Thorazin even being viable here. Like, why would it be useful? Unless you have a very spell-heavy deck. So, Jaraxxus is going to fix most of our problems here. Which is nice. Happy with that. That's good. And Reliquary Seeker, somehow. It's not going to happen. Not without implosion. It's not going to happen. Do I get rid of... I mean, I think you do. Even though he's only got like 2 cards in his hand. I don't think Thorazin matters here. I don't think it does. Because he only has 1 card and he's on 10 mana. Thorazin is not of importance. I think we can ignore him, actually. I don't think we have to deal with him at all. I would like to get Floating Watcher. I should have... tapped first, and then again I misplay. Sorry, it's late at night. I should have tapped first, Floating Watcher, then Jaraxxus. That would have been the correct play. The fact that I didn't do that makes me a dum-dum, but never mind. Worse things could happen, and I am going to take damage on my turn anyway. The thing is, I could have got a double buff out of this, so it's kind of disappointing that I didn't have that happen. I'm going to Demon Fire that. There we go. And now I have an 8-8, which... Let's see if you have two cards in your two cards. Can you deal with that? Please no polymorph. Please no polymorph. No polymorph? You don't have a polymorph, right? You wouldn't do that to me. Now. He's probably gonna- well, he obviously doesn't have a pyroblast, because that can kill me right now. Knife Juggle is a great card, but it's not gonna answer what I've got. Alright, I think we're in business. I think we are actually in- yeah, there we go, we did it! After two misplays with the Floating Watcher, we still do it anyway. Cool. This is a really fun brawl. Give it a try. It's a lot of fun. I like it a lot. I think there's so many different things you could do. As I say, I think you could do a Murloc deck, you could do a pure spell nuke deck, you could do a weapon heavy deck with a bit of AoE just to clear the board and just go swinging for the win. There's all sorts of things you do. I love it. I really wish they didn't end in 4 days, honestly. But there you go. There's my Hearthstone video, folks. There won't be content on the channel for the next few days outside of the podcast because I have my bi-weekly fortnightly chemo session, so that's gonna suck. I'm gonna be out of action for a couple of days, but after that, I'll be right back with more content. Thank you very much for watching, folks. If you enjoyed this video, then please, by all means, do feel free to click the like button. If you disliked it, if you are a filthy, filthy mage with your filthy, filthy Ronin strategies, then click the dislike button, and I'll see you next time.